Good evening, everybody, and welcome to the Camden Opera House. My name is Dave Morrison. I'm the Opera House manager. Tonight's soundcheck program, like all of our free live stream events, is supported by your donations to the Community Arts Fund. You can keep this series going by donating at camdenoperahouse.com. And if you have already, thank you so much. We really appreciate it. Tonight's concert is sponsored by our friends at the Mainstay Inn, who never hesitate to help us. I want to thank Janice and Peter Kesser for supporting live performances here in Camden. I also want to thank our good friends at WERU, who help us spread the word about these shows. And finally, I want to thank our staff, Juniper and Luke in the booth, Dagny, Matt, and Beth, who welcomed you in, all the folks who worked so hard to put this show together. So tonight, we're all in for something wonderful. Emily Holmes Hicks and Peter Zay are accomplished musicians and arrangers on their own, but when they pool their skills, it makes for a very special performance. Please welcome Larksgrove. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Yeah, we are just so thrilled to be here at this beautiful town of Camden and beautiful opera house, too. And we're, you know, we could, but we're not going to sing any opera for you today. We're not going to play any opera, but we do actually play opera. But Emmy and I met, I don't know, maybe about 10 years ago playing in an orchestra, playing a lot of classical music. But this first piece that we played for you was an arrangement by Natalie Haas and Alistair Fraser, two of our probably biggest inspirations for the fiddle music that we've been playing together. And this piece was probably the first fiddle tune, I think, kind of, that we played cello and violin together maybe 5 or 6 years ago or something like that. But to be honest with you, I'll tell you that because of the pandemic, we started doing a lot more of this, and it's become a thing. And so we are Larksgrove. And so we're going to do a combination of classical and fiddle today, but the classical is also pretty folky, so it's kind of a folk theme show for you today. And so I think we're going to now do something that we arranged. It's more of an improvisation, but we'll call it an arrangement. And the tunes are, what are the tunes, Emmy?
They are Jamie Allen and The Wren, two Irish tunes.
I forget a lot of stuff, so that's why she's there in case. Wait.
Thank you.
Thank you. Okay, so now we're going to head over to Europe and play some music by Borislav Martinu, Czech composer. Definitely very influenced by the folk music around him, the Bavarian and the music from Czechoslovakia at that time. And we're going to play two movements from this for you. It's a little different. Hope you like it. Thank you.
Thank you so much. We really appreciate you being here and coming on this musical journey with us. We always like to take an audience in kind of a unique journey with us, and every night is different every time we perform, and that's what makes it fun, partly what makes it fun for us to be musicians. So we really appreciate you being up for our whole journey, and we're gonna stay actually in Europe for one more piece. Another Czech composer, actually, Schulhoff, and we're gonna share two movements with you that he wrote in 1925. And I think you'll hear in these movements a lot of sort of avant-garde classical harmonies, but also kind of mixed with ragtime and jazz and a little of the Czech folk music as well. So these are two movements. Oh yeah, and I also wanted to share with you, especially in the first movement that we're gonna share with you, there's a couple of party tricks, and I'm not gonna maybe say too much more about the party tricks, but yeah.
Am I involved in this?
Yeah, you get a little bit of your own party tricks. I have maybe more, but yeah.
So just the regular, not the other ones, right?
Yeah. Just the regular. Yeah. Okay. So afterwards, maybe you can tell us what you think were the party tricks, but.
Well, before you ask that, so just to make sure though, does anybody out there play violin or cello? No, I don't think so. Or, well, you know, we have a live stream audience too, so, but they can't talk back. I don't think.
Thank you.
actually have one more movement to play from that, but I think I have to tune my cello. So I thought I would just ask if anybody knew what the party trick was in that. Does anybody know? Has anybody heard of the violinist Paganini? Sure, right, everybody. Like, you know, they compared him to the devil, right? So he's famous for that because he played so amazing. But anyway, he made a technique famous on the violin, which was using the left hand for, we call it pizzicato, Italian word, pizzicato. Right, so, yeah. That's the party trick. I did a little too.
Thank you.
hear that at a folk concert. First time? Maybe last time. Anyway, thank you so much. We're going to go back now, back to the fiddle world a little bit. Maybe it's also a little bit the funk world, the blues world, in this next tune, Valley of the Moon Reel by Alistair Fraser again, from Fraser and Haas. And this actually just kind of reminded me, because after this I'm going to pick up the guitar, but back many, many years ago, I played guitar, but I didn't play so much fiddle or folk, more like jazz and rock. So, and Emmy kind of discovered this, you know, over the years, and we just have enjoyed, we enjoyed learning about each other's musical journey, and that's kind of what we've brought together here today. So, but anyway, I've gone off a little bit on a tangent. The guitar will happen later. So here is Valley of the Moon Reel. Thank you.
Thank you so much. That's one of my favorite tunes, actually. There's something about it when I play it, I just feel like I'm relaxed on the beach or something. Right down the street on the Camden Beach. No. Actually, it's really fun to be here in Camden. I've spent many summers sailing up in Maine with my dad, and we always sail past Camden, but we never seem to stop in Camden. So it's fun to actually be here and see the town and see this beautiful hall. We're gonna play some tunes with the guitar now. I have to say that playing with Peter, there's a lot of fun things about playing with Peter, but one of them is that whenever I suggest something or have an idea, he's always up for it. So we're gonna play a couple Irish tunes for you, The Star of County Down and After the Battle of Aughrim.
Thank you.
So we love taking fiddle tunes and kind of messing with them and doing different things with them. Again, my ideas coming into play here. So we're going to take a couple of hornpipes, and we're going to turn them upside down and inside out and play them as an air and a jig and a hornpipe and some other things in there. Yes?
It gets really confusing.
Just so you know. Yes. It's Peter's puzzle.
Yes. And, well, actually, as Emmy likes to say when we're performing, you never know what's going to happen next. So that's kind of the way we work, I guess. No, I just think if that happened in our other job, playing in an orchestra, ooh, that wouldn't be good. You have to know what's going to happen next, because if one thing goes wrong and 80 people, you know, and believe me, it's happened.
Thank you.
own pitch on the fiddle. Yeah.
I think it might have gotten a little faster there at the end.
Yeah, well, she can actually play a lot faster than that, so we're just doing the relaxed version today. This is going way too fast. We're actually getting to the end, very close. So we'll see if we have time, but we have one more set for you. This is three tunes, Flying Home to Shelley, Kitchen Girl, and June Apple.
Thank you.
Yeah, well, so, we're going to leave you with a nice, calm waltz, which I can't pronounce, so Emmy will pronounce it.
This is called Mehitable's Waltz, and it's by a wonderful fiddler named Ben Schreiber. He is not from Maine. He lives in St. Louis right now.